Started.
Hi, good morning everyone. Sorry for the delay, there was some technical glitch, so we are a little late by about 30 minutes. So I'm Dr. Hailene here, a panel doctor with Predictive Homeopathy for the last 8 years. And So let's start with our continue with our Mayism book. And before starting, I would want to take blessings from Dr. Hanuman. Because of him, we have this beautiful science of homeopathy. And also, I would really want to take blessings of my mentor, my guru, Dr. Praful Vijayakar sir. Whatever I am, I'm totally indebted to him today in my practice. Whatever I have achieved is all because of him. So we take their blessings and we start without wasting more time. Okay, so today's chapter is chapter 10 about physical diseases of psora. So they have already covered what is psora, what is psychosis, what is syphilis, right, in the previous lectures. So psora is the first defense mechanism, psychosis is the second defense mechanism, and syphilis being the third defense mechanism in any kind of illness. Okay. So these are the three myasms that we have studied so far. Now we will study the pathologies, the physical diseases that you will be seeing in psora, psychosis and syphilis. Okay. So just to summarize the previous lectures, what is psora? First defense mechanism, any kind of inflammation. Okay. Psychosis, any kind of growths. Okay. Any kind of construction. Okay, that's the second defense mechanism. And syphilis, where is destruction? Any kind of destruction, be it necrosis, epilysis, apoptosis, you know, that is the third defense mechanism of the illness. Right? So what happens in psora? What is the pathogenesis in psora? So psoric diseases, so says, are characterized by altered sensibility, irritability, and acute inflammation. Okay? Itis, always remember. ITIS, any kind of inflammation, any kind of sensitivity, okay, you will find in psora. That's your body's first defense mechanism. Okay, so any irritation on the skin, any layer, okay, any kind of inflammation, okay, any kind of altered sensibility, like you know, any kind of senses altered or heightened sensitivity, okay, that will be seen here. Which is transient. Psoric illnesses are mostly acute inflammations, transient illnesses. Okay. These are not chronic. Most of the chronic inflammations will go into psychosis, prolonged, right? So you will find all kind of acute inflammations seen in psora, right? So when it comes to skin, so as mentioned, all kind of acute inflammations, basically hypersensitivity, irritability will be seen on the, so dermatitis, okay, and acute itching, okay, be it your boils, papular, your rash, miliary rash, okay, which we see in illness, any kind of oozing eczemas, cellulitis, okay. So these are in the initial stage. When they are acute, they are considered as psoric. Respiratory tract, you will find again rhinitis, pharyngitis, so inflammation of the nasal membranes, you know, pharyngitis, inflammation of your pharynx, tonsillitis, bronchitis, you know, inflammation of the alveoli, tracheitis, pneumonitis, pneumonia, etc. Okay, so this is all hypersensitivity reaction of that trachea causing asthmatic bronchitis also, you know, that's also psoric, right? Any kind of spasms, okay, suddenly the body goes into spasm, that is also first the body goes into spasm, it goes into inflammation. Okay, later on swelling and stiffness comes. That's so, psychosis. But initial that spasm is psora. Okay, and any kind of allergic manifestation. Suppose you know we inhale some people are allergic to dust. You know, hypersensitive to dust, strong odors. You know, so initial reaction will be rhinitis. Okay, So that is basically any kind of inflammation because of any kind of allergen, that is also sora, right? In GI tract, gastrointestinal tract, you will find again esophagitis, gastritis, gastric lining inflammation, you know, esophageal lining inflammation, any kind of hyperacidity, you know, stomach lining inflammation, colitis, colon inflammation, hyperperistalsis, you know, extra peristalsis is also in this, okay? Hypermotility, you know, when you have diarrhea, dysentery, you know, because of the hyperperistalsis, hypermotility, that's also seen in this. Diarrhea, your acute hepatitis, you know, because that's transient. Again, inflammation of the liver parenchyma, acute cholangitis, acute pancreatitis, okay? Acute proctitis, appendicitis, any kind of irritation due to the worms, okay? And your irritable bowel syndrome in the transient initial phase is also considered in sora, right? Am I clear? So you see, everywhere what we see is basically itis, itis, itis means inflammation. So any first defense is basically any kind of inflammation, you know, any kind of acute irritation, any hypersensitivity is listed under sora. That's your first body's defense. Whenever there is any irritation, okay, any kind of inflammation, body ka first defense is usko inflame karna, okay. That is basically, there's no structural abnormality here, there's no chronicity here, okay. It's basically just body is giving some kind of inflammation, irritation, okay, because of whatever, maybe a worm, infestation, can be because of indisposition, can be because of some kind of allergy, okay. So the reaction, the first reaction, the first defense of your body is the soric defense, and it is characterized by this. So clinically, you know, pathologically, we will find all of this in sora. Am I clear? Yeah? So far? Go to next. Now coming to the locomotor system, okay? So in that, again, same, you know, inflammation of the joints, you know, so you see acute arthritis, inflammation of the cartilages, okay, between the joints, between the vertebrae, the spondylitis, okay, your laryngitis leading to hoarseness, okay, so that also is because of this, myositis, okay, muscle inflammation, tendinitis, tendon inflammation, okay. The deeper tissues, example, the primary complex, pleuritis, endocarditis, pericarditis, vasculitis, stress diabetes, viral thyroiditis, meningitis, encephalitis, all these deeper tissues also, you know, when initial stage in the inflammation, the first effects are in the soric diseases, okay? Also, symptoms out of, suppose a person has developed temperature, you know, fever, maybe a viral attack or something, the first body's defense there also will be sora, okay? You will not directly go into a psychosis. So any kind of infections, you know, that first causes inflammation in the body, be it whatever layer, be it whatever system, the first defense has to be inflammation or some kind of irritation. So symptoms arising out of infections, jaisaki inflammation, so irritability, example, acute spasmodic pains, you know, this spasm again, you know, there's irritation, the body goes into a spasm, the muscle goes into a spasm, okay, of abdomen, or be it sciatica, you know, there's nerve inflammation, you know, so that is also there. Paroxysmal, so going, coming, paroxysmal, you know, in paroxysms, then neuralgic pain, neuralgias, you know, when in acute neuralgias, any kind of nerve inflammation, that's also a body soric defense. Also, convulsions caused by inflammations or irritations, okay? Now, this is not the convulsions which are caused by some kind of SOLs, you know, space occupying lesions in the brain, are psychotic, okay? Or, you know, the destructive pathology, there's some kind of atrophy in the cerebrum, you know, or any kind of destructive pathology which is giving rise to, you know, convulsions, that is syphilitic. But there are sometimes, you know, just febrile convulsions out of high temperature, or, you know, just because of some kind of inflammation, you know, in the brain, that, or any kind of irritation, that is very purely soric. Okay, so basically wherein there is inflammation in the nervous system. So even convulsions can be psora. Yeah. So sir says here, there's a note from sir. This is not an exhaustive list of psoric pathology. Any disease or symptoms at the origin of which lies hypoxia or ischemia, that is deprivation of respiration or the nutrition or evacuation or neural control of cells and tissues, can be clubbed into this list of disease. So even so that this whole thing, you know, is just not, you know, enough to be considered as psora. There are more, you know. So anywhere where there is any kind of nutrition lacking, you know, psoric, the first need is nutrition, right? So psoric need when not fulfilled, you know. So any kind of lack of nutrition in any part of the body, or any kind wherein oxygen, you know, is not being supplied properly. There's ischemia, okay? Any kind of initial ischemic changes, you know, hypoxia, okay? These all, or wherever, you know, the there is the loss of neural, you know, cells, or a loss of control, you know, basically. So these all things, you know, are the tissues which are undergoing some changes in the primary, you know, response to hypoxia or less oxygen, can be clubbed into psoric diseases as well. Okay, so not just that. Right? Okay. Also, behavioral changes or emotional changes, acute irritation at the neuroendocrinal level, especially at the juncture of the neurotransmitter production, may cause sudden bursts of anger, fright, grief, anxieties, which could be very transient but repetitive, are purely psoric in origin. That means, so sometimes, you know, you get some patients, like, you know, especially in psoric illnesses, you will find, like, you know, patient comes and complains, like, you know, कल अचानक से गुस्सा आ गया, सम काइंड, यू नो, हिज फर्स्ट रिएक्शन टू सम काइंड सिचुएशन वाज लॉट ऑफ एंगर, ओके, और सडन यू नो ग्रीफ, और यू नो काइंड ऑफ सम काइंड ऑफ लॉट ऑफ जॉय, ओके, एक्सेसिव जॉय. दिस ऑल आर ड्यू टू सम काइंड ऑफ चेंजेस एट द न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर लेवल. ओके, द जंक्शन वेर इन न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर्स, यू नो, लाइक सेरोटोनिन, डोपामिन, और एड्रेनालिन आर रिलीज्ड, यू नो. सो जैसे सेरोटोनिन, इफ समवन इज, यू नो, वेरी 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 हैप्पी, दैट्स अ फील गुड हार्मोन, यू नो, सो सेरोटोनिन इज रिलीज्ड. सो दीज, यू नो, एंग्जाइटी, यू नो, वेन योर स्ट्रेस हार्मोन इज, यू नो, देयर सम डिरेंजमेंट देयर, सो यू गेट लॉट ऑफ एंग्जाइटी. सो दीज आर ऑल initial emotional disturbances that are also changes at the psoric level, psoric in origin, because they are not a part of the they're not chronic. It's just that is a initial response to any kind of trauma. Okay, that's a psoric response, right? So these are also the, and this will be very transient, it's not a part of his nature, you know, but sometimes can be a repetitive, you know, but very transient. उस वक्त मुझे बहुत गुस्सा आया, उस वक्त बहुत बुरा लगा, ओके, या दैट टाइम बिफोर एग्जाम आई गॉट वेरी नर्वस. सो दीज आर वेरी ट्रांजिएंट इमोशंस. सो दीज आर बिकॉज ऑफ द चेंजेस इन द न्यूरोएंडोक्राइन लेवल, बिकॉज ऑफ द न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर, एंड दीज आर ऑल्सो सॉरी. ओके, सो एनीथिंग दैट इज वेरी ट्रांजिएंट, ओके, टेम्पररी, आर सोरा, अक्यूट. So when a disease shifts from one system to another, example, after the suppression of diarrhea or any kind of discharges from the respiratory tract, when you suppress, or, you know, when you treated with wrong medicine or allopathic treatment, you know, and you have suppressed the diarrhea, okay, and the patient has show signs of transient inflammatory process in cartilages and joints, this incorporates dynamism. Because up to pathology has not developed. So sora means very transient, very dynamic. Okay. It has to be that time. Okay. There's no pathology majorly developed yet. There's no structural change developed as in, you know, psychosis. There's no destruction yet happened. Okay. So anywhere, you know, even after suppression, you know, if patient comes with, you know, some kind of diarrhea, okay, but, you know, sudden inflammation in the brain goes into convulsions, or respiratory tract, you know, any kind of suppression goes into cartilage joint inflammation, don't consider it as psychosis because that's again dynamic. There's only inflammation. Okay, still कुछ pathology, exudation वगैरह नहीं हुआ है, develop नहीं हुआ है. So this is basically again psoriatic. So this incorporates dynamism. The pains can come and go before it becomes permanent in the new place. So just when there's a shift from one layer or one system to the other, and there's only dynamism, when there's only inflammation, not yet become permanent, you will find always patients coming with, you know, after diarrhea, मेरे को ना ये joint pain चालू हो गया है, right? But हमेशा नहीं रहता है, आता जाता रहता है. So when it is very transient or when it's very paroxysmal, intermittent, it is more of psoriatic. Because it's still not developed into a pathology. If it is a pathology, if it's a proper osteoarthritis, you know, or some kind of degeneration, you know, has happened, there will be constant pain. It will be a chronic pain every time there. But whereas in psora, it will be always transient. It will be always paroxysmal. Okay, this exhibition of dynamism is purely psoriatic because it translates itself into chronic inflammation. Before it translates into a chronic inflammation or a chronic RA, rheumatoid arthritis, which is autoimmune syphilitic in origin. So this is just transient and this has happened just immediately after suppression. That's not because, that's not psychotic or syphilitic because it's not become permanent. It's not caused any kind of pathological changes. So SIR says any kind of suppression like this, when there's a shift from one system to other, when there is shift from one layer to other, and if there is just dynamism, paroxysmal, intermittent, acute inflammation, it is purely psoriatic because it has yet not transformed into a chronic inflammation, into a chronic structural or a destructive change. Okay, always remember. So don't think every joint pain, you know, coming after a suppression, don't consider it as RA, you know, don't consider it as a degenerative osteoarthritis. It could be just psoriatic inflammation because of the suppression, because of change of pathology, change of layer. Okay, but symptoms could be very transient, could be very paroxysmal. Okay, won't be very you know, always chronic, you know, pain. It will be coming and going, aada jara pain. Aisa. Okay, am I clear so far? All good. Yeah, so most pains or some pains which are very transient, again relapsing, associated with high fevers or eruptions, could be psoriatic in origin. Okay, again SIR says, so any kind of pains which are again transient, relapsing, associated with some kind of high fevers, that is again inflammation, or eruptions are psoriatic purely. Okay, SIR says, but in fevers, malaria is not considered psora, it is more of psychosis. Okay, that's also relapsing fever, but it is not psoriatic. Physical structure. So how does a psoriatic face look like? Okay, so psoriatic face is a normal, very proportionate face. Okay, more or less a long face. Okay, with a tapering chin. They have sensitive eyes, medium sized nose, not too big or too small for the face. The face does not show any excess fat or roundness. The nose is neither too sharp or nor too rounded. Okay, and even the wounds which are psoriatic are not very, so the wounds are very clear cut but very superficial. Okay, neither very deep, it's very superficial, and nor it is destructive, you know, like ulcers which are jagged, okay, which are bleeding profusely, or the blackish discoloration are more into, you know, syphilis in origin. And any kind of wound which heals without a scar is psoriatic. Okay, so psoriatic face, always remember, is always very normal, proportionate, long face, tapering chin, not too small, not too, you know, big, very proportionate. The nose is also medium size. Eyes are very sensitive, you know, you'll find sensitive, very emotional, they convey emotions. Okay, not very manipulative and sly like we see in, you know, psychotic people. Okay, and even wounds physically, if you get some kind of injury which is sore, it will be very clear cut, not very deep, not, you know, causing any kind of severe pathology, not destructive, will be very superficial. Okay, and they heal usually without a scar. Yeah, all good so far? Okay. So that's for Sora. Now we come to this chapter 11, where you will see all the physical diseases of psychosis. That's the second body defense mechanism. Okay. So what do you see in psychosis? Okay, let's see the pathogenesis of psychosis. So Sora incorporates, we saw, the primary response to any kind of injury, cellular, okay, by sacrificing some kind of nutrition or oxygenation, giving rise to inflammations or hypoxia. It is the first basic function of the cell, okay, of an organism. Now psychosis is the secondary response, okay, after there has been already some kind of hypoxia, some kind of initial inflammation, irritation, which is very transient. Second defense body cup is psychosis. Now when there is a secondary response to any kind of cell injury brought about by using or sacrificing the second function of either generation or reproduction. So first defense, they sacrifice either the nutrition or oxygen and give rise to hypoxia and inflammation. In second defense, the body will sacrifice by giving the function of, the second function is basically production, generation, okay, construction. Okay, reproduction, multiplication. So when this is sacrificed, that goes into a secondary defense mechanism, that's psychotic. So we know that the generation, the any kind of reproduction or generation in any kind of cell occurs due to many processes, right? But for cell division, okay, we have studied this. So any kind of cell division, there's a process called as mitosis, okay. So this process of division is so perfect, so says, and so meticulous in us that any cell can give rise to two, right? So basically that a cell can give birth to two of its own kind, okay, that exactly resembles the parent cell, okay. That means the cell divides in the ratio of 1:2, okay, except in case of meiosis. So now the secondary defense response sacrifices this second function of reproduction or generation. Okay, so whenever there is a cellular injury, there's been a response of sacrificing the oxygen or the nutrition, and the body goes into defense mechanism wherein we see inflammations, right? Now when the body, the cellular injury goes beyond that, so body will go and sacrifice reproduction or any kind of generation, that is this mitotic process, okay, where the body has a capacity of giving rise to another two cells which replicate the parent cell. So now in secondary response, this sacrifices this second function of the cell. This means something has to go wrong with the generation or the production or the reproduction, okay, by 1:2. So, jo 1:2 normally hona chahiye, wo nahi ho raha hai. That has been sacrificed. So, if the reproduction ratio of this 1:2 is changed, it could either be more or less. So, either the multiplication would be more, so that's hyperpsychosis, or it could be less, that could be hypopsychosis. So, maybe jaise 1:2 hona chahiye hai division, that may go into 1:4, 1:2, or it can go into less than more, 1:2. That is hypopsychosis. It's very important, huh? So the cell can thus start multiplying in ratio of 1:2, or the cell can start multiplying in the ratio of 1:1, less than 2. Okay. The first is psychosis excess, hyperpsychosis, and the second condition can be psychosis less, that is hypopsychosis. Okay. Hence, psychosis can be expressed in all the ways and in all the systems and the tissues in two forms, excess and less. The diseases or pathological states, both on the physical as well as mental level, will be expressed as excess. So, too much grief, too much anger, you know, too much chronic grief, okay, too much anxiety, okay, too much fear, okay, these are all mental state psychosis, excess, okay, less also, you know, physically also, you know, any kind of laxity, okay, tissues which are very loose, prolapses, again will be hypopsychosis. Psychosis can be expressed in all the systems and tissues in two forms, excess or less. Now we see the examples. So what do you mean by cellular, at the cellular level, okay, and the humoral level, at the nuclear level, okay. So psychosis excess, first we'll see the examples, okay. So at the cellular level, the size itself can be big, hyper, okay. So that is causing hypertrophy of the cell, there's excess growth, okay. The construction may be due to increase in the number of the cells, so there is hyperplasia because of excess multiplication, okay, so that 1:2 ratio is more than 2, okay. At the cellular nucleus level, at the humoral level, okay, now cell can be divided into more than 2 nuclei cells, right, resulting into warts, okay, growth, or some kind of excrescences, okay, again the kind of growth, skin tags, okay, polyps, etc. So the size of the part or the organ is big, bigger than the normal, okay. So when there is at the cellular level, you will find thickenings or hyperplasia, hypertrophy. At the humoral level, that part or organ will be bigger, okay. So some kind of growth, tags or, you know, polyps, warts, that you will see, okay, at the humoral level in psychosis excess. Now when it comes to the cellular wall, okay, now in blood especially, we will see, suppose there is, in case of psychosis excess, in case of, first we'll only do excess and then we'll do, yes, so in lipids, okay, so you will find hypercholesterolemia, hyperlipidemia, hypertriglyceridemia, you know, when your triglycerides are increased. So at the cellular wall level, you know, lipids, proteins, carbo, you know, diabetes, so proteins, there will be hyperproteinemia, ketosis, hyperalbuminemia, hyperglobinemia, okay, diabetes, again, you know, when your sugar, your carbs are high in the blood level, okay, you will find diabetes. At the cell cytoplasm, okay, when there is the water in the cytoplasm, right, electrolytes and your water combines the cytoplasm, right, around the cell wall. So the water, whenever there is excess water in the body, what you see? Swellings, right? Any kind of edemas, you know, retention of water, okay? Ascites, your anasarca, you know, your cystitis, your, cysts basically, no, not cystitis, sorry. Your, any kind of turgidity, you know, excess, blisters, any kind of water retention, anywhere, any part, skin, anywhere, is, or vesicular eruption, where again, there is water in the vesicular eruption. You will find these kind of pathologies, okay. Then sodium, electrolyte imbalance, so you know, when sodium goes high, hypernatremia, potassium, hyperkalemia, okay, these are all relating to the cell cytoplasm. Hypercalcemia, uric acid increases gout, ketone is ketosis, excess fibrin in the cellular, you know, level, any kind of hardness, you know, fibrosis, your fibroids, indurations, arteriosclerosis, when the blood vessels are thickened up, you know, these are all excess of fibrin, okay. Excess elastin will give rise to any kind of constrictions, strictures, any kind of stenosis, you know, thickening, okay, is because of excess elastin. Any kind of depositions or any kind of accumulations may be due to excess generation, excess reproduction, okay. So hypercalcification, your stones, calcium oxalate, your renal calculi, renal stones, you know, salivary gland calculus, you know, tartar on the teeth, phlebolites, you know, so these are because of deposition. So again, excess deposition is excess generation, okay, that gets deposited. Melanocytes, you know, hypermelanosis, you know, you see hyperpigmentation because of excess melanocyte activity, okay, on the skin, or any kind of blackish discoloration, that is melanocytosis. Any kind of brown pigment excess, you know, you see pigments, females coming with brown spots, lipofusion, any kind of liver spots, you know, iron, there's hemosiderosis. Okay, and bones may you will see any kind of growth excess, you know, increased growth or any kind of increased osteophytes, you know, any kind of calcaneous spots, again osteophytes increase, osteomas, these are all at the bone level. Blood vessels, so blood vessels you will find all your hemangiomas, your angiomas, varicoses, you know, aneurysms, hemorrhoids, again, you know, lack of elasticity. So you will find blood vessels in all of this. Uterus, I already told you, it's increased fibrin, fibroids, your cyst is accumulation, okay, polyps, endometriosis, okay, again fibrin and collagen excess. Skin, you will find your callosities, corns, excrescences, your warts, your fungal nematodes, your ringworms, any kind of thickened margins, thickening, hypertrophy, everything on at the skin level. This is all your psychosis. Any tumor or growth anywhere in the body, example brain, stomach, lungs, liver, kidney, even extra flaps at the lower end of the uterus, called as posturetral valves, you know, any extra growth, any tumor, anywhere on the body, you know, is psychotic. Okay. So how is physical constitution in hyperpsychosis? You will find overall very large build, you know, long bones, sturdy bones, you know, well developed cheek and face bones, squarish, roundish face. Now, well developed bony prominences are due to hyperpsychosis or psychosis excess. Now, psychosis less we will see. Okay, so the cell size is small, right? So again, same, you know, lipids mein you will see hypolipidemia, protein mein hypoproteinemia, decreased albumin, decreased globulin. Okay, hypoglycemia, sugars going low, glucose going low. You know, fibrin mein again less of fibrin. Okay, any less of fibrin go give rise to less hardness. Okay. And more softness, this could result in any kind of dilatations, you know, basically whenever there is less fibrin there are dilatations. So basically heart may, you know, you, whenever you find dilatation, any kind of organ there are dilatation, think of this. Psychosis, elastin less, you know, so whenever there is less elastin results in relaxation. Okay, less fibrin, dilatation, less elastin is relaxation. Okay, so prolapsus, so any kind of prolapse, your ptosis of the eyelids or vitrectosis, prolapsed heart valves, you know, and your hernias, prolapsed rectum, varicose veins, hemorrhoids are all examples of lack of elastin. Okay, calcium, so hypocalcemia. Okay, calcium deposit less, osteoporosis. Melanin, reduced melanin may give rise to hypopigmentation. Okay, orthenia versicola, it's not leucoderma, mind you, leucoderma is destruction. Okay, that is syphilitic autoimmune. Iron, any kind of anemia, less hemoglobin. Okay, less iron stores. Physically, haven't you seen psychosis less? It's basically small bit of people, short fingers, short bones, okay, underdeveloped organs or parts are all psychosis less. Okay, in general, psychosis constitution in general. Okay, now we saw the difference in large hyposis, psycho excess, psychosis excess, and psychosis less. You know, the psychosis excess will be long, sturdy bones, bony prominently, okay, tall, whereas psychosis less will be short fingers, short stature, okay, short bones, underdeveloped organs. In general, now psychosis is basically rounded contours. Okay, there are fat, flabby, excess of everything, flesh, excess of bones. Okay, squarish or rounded faces, and a large nose is psychosis excess. And in psychosis less will be a very small nose. So something which is not very proportionate, like we saw in Sora. Okay, something not very disproportionate also is either excess or less. Okay, so So this was very easy so far. So we did we did Sora, your physical, you know, pathologies, okay, the how will you see at the cellular level, or physically how will you see, you know, or the features. Then we did the psychosis, now again there's excess, there's less, that's the second difference, okay, how body compromises or sacrifices the reproduction, the generation, okay, and goes into these two mechanisms, right? And then how do we see psychosis, excess at the cellular level, humoral level, and different organs level, okay, pathologies developed there. And similarly, psychosis, excess at the different levels in the body, different organs at different tissue levels, okay. And physically, how would they appear in psychosis, excess and psychosis, less, okay. And then you saw in general, psychotic features will be more rounded, squarish, you know, anything excess or anything less, something which is not very proportionate, like Sora. So now we will see what in syphilis looks like. So what is syphilis? Syphilis is the third defense of the body, right? So any kind of destruction. So first defense is inflammation. Second defense, construction, sacrifice. Third defense is destruction. Okay? So any kind of destructive pathologies or any kind of autoimmune processes, you will find here. So destruction of a part or self-destruction, autoimmune, apoptosis is a part of syphilis, okay, or any kind of something which is abnormal, out of normal, okay, something which is exaggeration, okay, or hysteria, something which is not normal is syphilis, which is out of control, okay, that is syphilis defense mechanism. Okay. So what do you see in the pathogenesis of syphilis, or we call it the destructive diseases? The source says, when a cell cannot cope up with the invading organism or the pathogen or the toxin by using the physiologic defense, that is compromising on the nutrition or oxygen, or the second defense, that is the constructive reproduction, when the cell, you know, is not able to cope up with these two mechanisms, these two defenses, it decides in despair to adopt to a do or die situation. Okay, now body has tried, you know, or body has tried with inflammation, body has tried with, you know, compromising on the reproduction. But when body is not able to cope up with these two mechanisms, you know, and it's failed, so body will say, ab mujhe bachana hai kaise bhi. Okay, it's a do or die situation. What will you do, you know, when you've been attacked? First attack, aap bachaoge apna, okay, aap dar jaoge, ghabra jaoge. Second attack, aap shield rakhoge, psychosis, cover kar loge, okay, chup jaoge. वो भी काम नहीं कर रहा है, ओके, कोई बंदूक लेके आ गया है तो क्या करोगे, राइट? सो दिस इज अ डू डाई सिचुएशन. सो दैट टाइम द सेल सेज, आई हैव टू सेव द होल, आई हैव टू सेव द ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो इट विल डिस्ट्रॉय दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट और ऑर्गन, ओके. सो ऑफ द 100 trillion सेल्स इन आवर बॉडी, यू नो, एवरी सेल एज द टेक्स्ट बुक्स ऑफ पैथोलॉजी टीचर्स अस lives and works to maintain the biological equilibrium. We all believe that, we've read in the earlier book. So to maintain that homeostasis, okay, body always works, every cell in our body, you know, God has, you know, designed it so beautifully, everything is so beautiful, so meticulously, it works to maintain a harmony in the body, to maintain a balance of equilibrium, okay, to maintain that homeostasis, okay, that's the part of every cell. In the human being, if this equilibrium is maintained, that is the homeostasis is maintained, the whole being, the whole person remains healthy, there is no disease. This eases when there is derangement in the vital force, or derangement in the equilibrium, derangement in the homeostasis of the body, that's when there is an illness. This means that every cell has concern for the whole body, whole being, every cell works towards that. When the whole being is under attack, okay, by anything, organism, pathogen, toxin, anything, etc., it may decide to either sacrifice itself or, okay, to save the whole. So either it will decide, so first mechanism failed, first defense failed, second defense failed. So now it has to work to save the whole. So it decides, okay, I will sacrifice this.
Okay, not just sacrifice, thus a cell tissue, cell of tissue, or a part of the whole human being may be either distorted, disfigured, or even degenerated if required to save the whole human being.
Okay, so this is the third defense. So when the body decides ki now I have to save the whole person, you know, I don't have to. So that's the main motive of the body, to maintain equilibrium. Now that's not been maintained. So body will say, okay, I will sacrifice one part to save the whole. So you will find any kind of distortion at any level, okay, or any kind of disfigurement or any kind of degeneration that is syphilitic in nature. That is basically merely to save the whole human being, okay. Now this degeneration is by two means, okay, either necrosis or apoptosis, also known as apolysis. What do you mean by necrosis?
So necrosis is basically a process by which the body discards the disease part, okay, that can be dangerous to the whole being, okay. So wo part ko they will degenerate, okay. This is brought either by karyolysis, okay. Again, karyolysis is breakdown of the DNA, degeneration of the DNA, okay. So necrosis are basically main necrosis are, you know, coagulative, there's liquefactive, there's fat necrosis, okay. So coagulative is very common, liquefactive, you know, wherein big tissues are involved, fat necrosis is wherein fatty tissues, you know, are involved, you know, pancreas, liver. So these are the ways ki body will decide, okay, either hum necrosis करेंगे, इधर हम degeneration करेंगे to save the whole human being, okay, इधर breakdown होगा. Disease symptoms encountered in the syphilitic necrosis, you will find pathologies like gangrene, okay, any kind of distortions of any kind of parts of the body, like, you know, rheumatoid arthritis पे you'll find distortion of the bones, right, disfigurements, okay, any kind of bad ulcers, lacerations, bleeding excessive, any kind of sensitivity which is out of proportion, okay, always remember, anything abnormal, out of normal, out of all proportion is syphilitic, okay, any kind of exaggeration. So any deep wounds, deep bleeding, internal bleeds, you know, going on, or any kind of distorted ulcers with jagged margins, you know, deep ulcers, chronic ulcers, you know, distorted healing wounds which don't heal easily are all part, you know, especially gangrenes, very old gangrenes, always, you know, with lot of bleeds, is kind of necrotic in syphilis. Now what happens in apoptosis? Apoptosis means any kind of process, you know, by which different parts of the body undergo a programmed death, okay, programmed destruction, self-destruction, okay, to save the whole being. So the death of a cell is due to activation of the internally controlled suicide mechanism. वो बोलेगा मैं खुद को ही मार लेता ये पार्ट को, okay, to save the whole. So this is basically self-destruction. It is programmed, okay, suicide mechanism. The doomed cells, the affected cells are removed with minimum disruption to the surrounding. So they don't touch the surrounding. That particular part, the particular affected cells cause a self-death. Okay? The disease encountered in this type are all the autoimmune diseases. Like, you know, like RA, you know, your motor neuron diseases, your demyelinating diseases. All your autoimmune diseases will be seen in this apoptosis, because body will try to put the gun towards themselves, okay. So the gun of destruction is pointed towards self, okay. So in this homeopathically you will also see, even at the mental level, you know, such people have this reproaching, you know, self guilt, you know, anxiety concern, mere wajah se ye hua hoga, you know, they, I don't want to trouble unko, you know, so much self-inflicting, you know, very obvious. So these constitutions have a tendency to destroy self, okay. They will suffer, but they will not complain to others, you know, dusre ko meri wajah se takleef nahi ho, okay, aur they'll keep, mere wajah se ye hua hoga, you know, maine hi galti hogi. such constitutions, you know, will always suffer in the long run from autoimmune diseases. And those are violent not on self but on the outs. And this is violent on self. But people who are violent on others, okay, not on self, will always suffer from other destructive diseases, that is necrotic. Okay, because there's no self-destruction, there's destruction of the part. Okay, so people who are violent, you know, very severe mania, severe, you know, violent angers, you know, throwing things, they are destructive on others. That is, or they will go into necrotic syphilis. People who are destructive towards self, reproaching towards self, self-inflicting anger, you know, self-tormenting, that is more of autoimmune diseases. They will go into apoptosis. Okay, remedies that are self-destructive are the ones that think about suicide, you know, all the suicidal dispositions in remedies, especially like Auramet. Okay, Auramet always is into, you know, like we usually think of Auramet for suicides because they always think, you know, they have lot of the only emotion they have is anger. Okay, and they always think, you know, mere wajah se ye hua, I should not do anything to harm others, you know, mere wajah se unko takleef nahi hona chahiye. It's very duty oriented remedy. Okay, social position concerned about, it wants to do something. So it's not out of care that they do things, you know, for society. It is out of duty. They feel it's my duty. And when they're not able to achieve that, they feel, oh, it's because of me. So they go into that suicidal mode. Okay, meri galti thi, reproach mein chale ja. But and others say chloric acid will never destroy. Chloric will never destroy himself. Okay, they will be violent towards the other beings. Okay, but lead to external destruction. So they will be seen in destructive other necrotic pathologies. Okay, so like nose mein there is ozena, you know, caries ke liye is a very good, nasal cartilages mein. Then ulcerations. So mouth, stomach, duodenum, colon, rectum, or any kind of ulcers are syphilitic. Chronic or acute renal failure. So again, destruction, failure, right? Infarcts, again, infarcts in the heart. Atelectasis of the lung, this excess fibrin causing compromise on the body's breathing and capacity of the lungs. Any kind of interstitial fibrosis, emphysemas, cancers, okay? Cancers is again abnormal multiplication, not a normal tumor. Okay, it's not normal reproduction excess. It's abnormal, which is you cannot control. Okay, then there is cancerous ulcers. Okay, any kind of autoimmune diseases, we just read about them, like rheumatoid arthritis, autoimmune thyroiditis, you know, your Hashimoto's. Okay, self, again, you know, self damage. Your alopecias, right? Your vitiligos, any kind of gangrene, okay? Any kind of nerve degeneration, the demyelination, you know? Again, an autoimmune motor neuron diseases, you know? Parkinson's, your cerebral paralysis, you know? Etc., etc. There's a whole list, you know? These are the few that you will see in syphilis. The core is destruction, self or the path. Okay, to save the whole again, right? So understood. So now physical structure. So these were the pathologies that were associated with syphilis, right? How will be the syphilis face or physical structure? So something that repels you, something which is not very nice, you know, something that is just not normal. Again, out of normal, abnormal. Falls right here also, you know, falls true here also. Something which is not very appealing, okay? Ugly, distorted, disfigured, repulsive, you know, something which you don't want to see, okay? Nose and eyes can be extra sharp like a dagger. So something which is abnormal, right? That kind of figure, that kind of, any kind of disfigurements, you know, or like cleft palate, again a disfigurement. So those kind of pathologies also, you know, you will find in syphilis, right? So far clear? So ugly looking, basically. Or, you know, sometimes we see some young people coming and looking like old looking, you know, ugly looking faces. Yeah, wrinkled skin, you know, not for the age, something which is abnormal again. Yeah, okay, all good. So far, all good. I think we are done with all the three. Yes. Should we start with the chapter? I think we are done with the time also. We have 10 minutes. Okay, I'll just start this and then maybe we can see. So now, genetics. So Sir has always, you know, correlated modern science with homeopathy, how myosin and genetics work together. Okay, you know, we see most of the genetic cases which has no scope anywhere, you know, any kind of genetic abnormality which has no scope in allopathy, but we've seen amazing results with homeopathy. How has this been possible is all because Sir has explained to us, you know, how genetics work, you know, how your myosin and genetics work together and how they relate. So defense and myosin, we proceed to see what influence does defense and myosin have on a man. Okay, if the genetic code of the individual is tainted with or polluted, basically stained with or have traces of certain behavior, it is bound to lay an impact on every part of the cell. So genetics also plays a major role. Okay, so ek hota hai miasmatic influence, okay, and one is the genetic, the inherent, you know, the genetic code, you know, the constitution that will also have an imprint on that behavior of that person. Okay, and that could be not just mentally, also physically. So genetic predispositions we talk about. So the physical structure. So Sir always says this, survival of the fittest, right? In Darwin's theory. So the fittest always survives because it evolves a strategy to defend itself. Okay? This strategy is encoded in its genetic code. Okay? Every species has its own species-specific genome. Every genome has its common mode of defense encoded in its very genetic code, okay, plus the individual mode of defense. So there's one mode of defense genetically imbibed and one is that individual's defense, okay. So it is very obvious therefore that every species of animals is so different from each other, you know. How every individual is different, even the species of animals are very different. They have their own defense mechanisms. For example, okay, rabbits will not frighten anybody. Who could do that? They were timid, right? They will not go and scare someone. Dogs may or may not. Some dogs are very pally, you know, some dogs are very aggressive, right? Tiger and lion will frighten, okay? Everybody without exception. So all these, why? Because that's their constitutional, that's their genetic, you know, expression. So that's all embedded, encoded in their genes. Okay? So they are either timid like a rabbit or a cow or a cat, or they are so aggressive like a tiger or a lion. So that's embedded in the gene. Okay? This is the gene response. So the genome of dogs could have either qualities. Now some dogs may be very timid, on the other hand there may be other who are very ferocious like tigers. This again highlights that though dogs belong to the same species, their individuality is which cause? Understanding? So it's the genetic predisposition of that species, okay, also the individual. Now human beings, we are known to be more having more intellect than any organism. Okay, so but again, every individual has a different intellect, different intelligence. So all the dogs, you know, may not be pally. There may be someone ferocious, there may be someone which is very friendly. So that's not the genetic constitution of the dog. That's basically the genetic individual constitution of the dog. Okay, so the species, they don't have this. So tiger, the species, every tiger will frighten you. Every tiger will be violent and ferocious. Okay? But at the individual level, it can differ. Understanding? This again highlights that though dogs belong to the same species, there is individuality which comes. These innate qualities have been so designed depending upon the needs of that organism to fight for survival. Okay? This is true for all human beings also, as I just explained. As we know, the genes make a man or any living being. These genes are responsible for the physical, mental, and other tolerances, intolerances, or any susceptibility genetically.
Okay.
So if genes have timidity and lack of will as one of the qualities, then compensatorily there are other qualities the genes have to or must develop to create a balance so that individual survives. What does this mean? That means, for example, a person, okay, possesses a gene quality of being timid, okay, weak will. Then it is obvious that this timidity can never make him fight a battle for survival. Okay, this quality cannot give him toughness, okay, needed to frighten or fight the opponent. Therefore, it has to be endowed with the innate characteristic to either escape, okay, like, or to resign, or to be mild with no confidence, okay, in oneself, or to be bashful, or to hide, etc., etc. Okay, so all these negative innate characteristics basically develop as a reaction of the negative will. So, example, rabbit. Okay, now innate characteristic is timid, right? So either he will run, escape, right? So your whatever the gene, you know, if it is timid, it cannot fight. So the reaction can be various. अब जो fight नहीं कर सकता, इधर वो भाग जाएगा, okay? या वो mild रहेगा, पंगा ही नहीं लूँ, okay? या वो एकदम he will resign, give in to, okay? Or he'll be very bashful, will not speak. So these are different reactions. But the main genetic tendency, the innate characteristic is timid. Reaction can be different, okay? And these are all characteristic developed to a reaction of being having a negative will. Okay, so we see, you know, in case taking take will, your sensitivity, but what is us bande ka, even if he is a negative will, what is his reaction? That is individual, that's not. So there is one genetic tendency or a genetic predisposition or a susceptibility, but the reaction can be different. Understood? So all these qualities that the individual possesses are to defend itself, okay, from any kind of hostilities, to guard itself and therefore prolong his life, survive, survival of the fittest, okay. On the other hand, if the individual has a positive will, okay, he will develop lot of confidence, okay, pertinacity, can be very stubborn, obstinacy, okay, to help him in the perseverance or survive. Or may also develop a lot of aggression, anger, rage as its main weapon. You know, gusse se hi mera kaam chalega. Okay, if I'm angry, then only people will listen. So that's their defense, okay, to survive. Now, what is true in the mental plane is also true at the physical plane. Okay, body, mind first, and then the body reflects exactly the same. Right, we have learned that. Now, the features of the individual also develop in response to the basic nature. So, almost as a rule, mild or tamed animals, jo bahut timid aur, you know, jinko tame kar sakte hai, like a rabbit, sheep, cow, dog, have their face, jaws and incisors projected ahead, okay, ahead, to form a narrow tapering face as if to frighten the opponent. That's their genetic defense mechanism. Because they're timid, okay, that's just a projection, okay, to show, to frighten, okay, the opponent. On the other hand, the lions and tigers' ferocious look does not necessarily have too much projections to show. They don't lion ko canine dikhane ki zarurat nahi hai, you know, because internally uspe itna confidence hai. But the timid the person, so you will always find patients or children who are very timid, they will have target, you know, age pointed, okay, because they're timid. That's the innate, that's the expression at the physical level, because mentally they're timid. But similarly, a person who's very confident, you know, lion, ferocious, aggressive lion, doesn't need to show, are mere paas ye hai, wo sirf darane ke dar, okay, because he's confident, aayega main maar dunga, you know. A dog, a rabbit is not confident, so he will only show. That's a projection, that's a facade. So that's psychotic difference. Similarly, things have been observed in humans too. Not as a rule, but many times, timid calcarea patients have their upper teeth projected outwards. I told you just now. All this, of course, comes under the purview of physiognomy. Okay, so the science, wherein we study the features, okay? Which is not our topic here for now. Okay, this is only to heighten one fact that man, his structure and nature develops purely as a reaction, or rather defensive reaction to the hostile stimulus. Understood?
So beautiful.
Which it faces from the outside or from the inside or in the terms of nature he possesses. So anything physically also that we see, you know, is nothing but a defense reaction, okay? To survive, or, you know, could be a reaction to the stimulus, maybe from internally or externally, in, or it could be just genetic nature that he possesses. Okay? So, Sir says, the physical structure therefore is defense oriented. How we saw, they make the psychotic defense. Okay, it's a facade, right? So it's all defense oriented. Okay. So physical reactions, the tolerance, the intolerance to various stimuli like sun, wind, rains, damp, cold, heat, noises, colors, touch, emotions, further decides how the concerned individual should react in different circumstances. Got it? Okay. These reactions to the situations, okay, is the general makeup, okay, of that individual. Okay. Basically are that person's defense mechanisms at work, okay, and hence defense oriented. These are again influenced by the genetic code of that person, okay. So also mentally, you know, the mental reaction solely depend on the intelligence of the individual, okay. The intellect, the will, you know, the morals, etc. will allow that person to react according to his needs and circumstances, okay. That's his defense that time. These innate characteristics of the reactive mechanism, okay, the attitude defenses together with susceptibility makeup of the mental aspect of the individual, which in turn is governed by the genetic code. Okay, so the mental responses are more genetic. Okay, the physical reactions are more genetic but influenced by the defense mechanisms. Okay, so this, the will, the moral, the intellect is mainly determined by that person's reactive mechanism, but again controlled by the genetic code, okay, governed by that individual's genetic code. Okay, so the genetic code decides the reaction, okay, of an individual to an action. Very simple example, okay, if a person throws a stone on a group of standing people, okay, the reaction of every person is going to be different, right, governed by his individual genetic code. So one person could be fast enough to see the stone coming at him and take bhag jayega, okay, evasive reaction. Another could take a back or back, be very suppressed, oh, bachar gaya, frightened, okay, by the stone hold at him and become frightened or panicky. But the third one might not even be keen or sharp enough to notice the stone at such short interval of time and get struck badly, okay, or take a wrong evasive action. Or a fourth might get angry, okay, at the situation and catch the stone and give back, okay. So a fifth might not even realize what has happened, and after he's struck down he realizes that mere pe kisi ne patthar phenka, you know. So these are different reactions controlled by your genetic code. Now what is the analysis here? The first, okay, who is very sharp, before it's heard, he understood and he analyzed and he ran. So the first may be like this is cannabis opium, a quick intelligent mind which takes fast immediate decisions, you know. The second may be aconite, you know, frightened, phlegmonium, argentum, very finicky, nervous, timid, impulsive, panic personality whose every reaction is panic, okay. The third may be calcarea, jealous, hellebore, baraitakov, too slow to take decisions, jab tak wo samajh aaya it's too late, you know, and does not have a discretion, ye karu ki wo karu, okay, or taking right decisions. The fourth may be a very rebel, revolting type, okay, like a merc, causticum, naksamiga, oh, tune mara le, tu wapas le, okay, give back attitude, hates to be intimidated, hates usko ko irritate kare, okay. And the fifth probably a confused personality like a buffo or a baraita, you know, so aake gir diya usko but usko samajh nahi aaya, you know, or he takes a wrong decision. has no capacity to take decisions or think and understand the gravity of the situation. Okay, that is a Bofora Barata. So that's how, and this is determined by your genetic code. Okay, simple. Disease pathologies, as we already saw, are due to the three defense mechanisms. So physically at work, like all the properties of a cell, even the three defense responses to a stimulus are genetically covered. Okay, so at the disease at the pathology level, okay, what we see is nothing but the defenses working, but again they are genetically governed. Okay, that's the genetic susceptibility that they have. Suppose some people have a tendency, a strong genetic tendency of cancer in the family, or a strong genetic tendency for making cysts or calculi. Okay, so the genetic code, you know, the genetic susceptibility decides, and that governs the defense mechanism of that individual. Understood? So whether the cell should inflame, indurate, or ulcerate depends upon the genetic code of that individual. Got it? So it's decided by your genes, you know. He will go into either inflammation, illnesses, psychosis, or any kind of destructive pathology. Yeah, just say dog can be both, tiger has to be ferocious, so destruction mein hi jayega. Okay, timid will go into some timid, you know, psychotic only illnesses. So that is decided by your genetic code. What defense mechanism the body will adapt, okay, whenever there is an injury. The very existence of the man is defense oriented. Okay, there has to be a defense to fight, to survive. Okay, even the physical structure is defense oriented. The mental behavior, the attitude is defense oriented. Everything is defense oriented. Even diseases which he suffers is defense oriented. This means the physical, mental, general disease susceptibility of an individual depends upon the defense. We know that all these makeups are arising from the genetic code, are genetically governed. Yeah, everything, the main base is gene. Okay, and everything that governs, is being governed by the genes, is your defenses, your myosins. The genes will decide, you know, has to be a psoric or a psychotic or a syphilitic. It is embedded in your genes already. So this is how they are related. But everything is defense oriented. All reactions, be it mental, physical, the disease susceptibility, everything. And who governs this? Your genetic code. Easy? So if all these are defense oriented, then even the cures, the real cure, should be defense oriented. So the aim of the real cures has to be by boosting the defense mechanism of the individual rather than attacking the hostile stimulus. Rightly so, Dr. Hanneman denounced the concept of treating the disease in man and proposed the concept of treating the man in disease. Understood? So don't treat that bacteria. Don't treat that infection. Treat the whole person. Because why he is responding to the bacteria, his defense is basically governed by his genetic code, right? So treat the whole man, you know. Now genes, you can't specifically treat one gene. That's what the allopaths do, right? Specifically treating one organ. No, treat the whole part. Okay, because that's what governs your body's pathology, your body's defense, the myosin. He proposed that the treatment should be done only by taking into consideration the mental, physical makeup, general makeup, all of which are the products of the genetic code and hence reflects the defensive trait or the myosome of that person. Okay, thus all the reactions essentially defensive to help individual to evade any kind of injury and survive are built up on the innate characteristics which are acquired or inherited by the individual. These innate characteristics are also decide the physical stature, structure, contours, which again is decided to defend and survive. The whole genetic setup of an individual is designed to ensure that the mind, the physique tolerances, likes, dislikes, as well as the susceptibility to diseases are designed for prolonged survival of that individual. So, myosin is defense. Defense is influenced by the genetic code. So, we can safely deduce that myosin is influenced by the genetic code.
Understood? So, every individual that inherits from parents or acquires any kind of qualities to defend itself mentally and physically, these qualities are already imprinted in his genes, you know, or the genetic code. That are his genetic traits. Thus, a soric constitution is the constitution or makeup of an individual which is designed physically, mentally, generally to defend physiologically, only cause inflammation. Similarly, a psychotic constitution morphologically, you know, is designed mentally, individually to replicate constructively, okay, and syphilitic constitutionally will morphologically cause destruction. Okay, this is all MY. Understood? Yeah, that's all. Now the next person will continue with the next lecture. Hopefully it was so far very easy. Anuses, very easy. Okay, pathologies we did. Flora, psychosis, syphilis, and we also deduced how the myosins and genes are related. Okay, fine. Any questions, please message on the chat box. I will reply after this. Thank you so much for listening to me. Thank you.